Hello, it is Delight Channel once again, where we have been talking about retirement. We have been focusing on financial preparation over the last 2-3 videos, and last week I pointed out that living on a budget to create a savings is a means to an end. It is not the end in itself. The real end we are pursuing is to be in a position where when you stop working for money, your money starts to work for you. And therefore, I promised last week to say, how do you get your money to work for you? There are a few things that you can do to make you be in a position where your money begins to work for you. And I will be going through a few of them so that you could have an awareness, not necessarily an exhaustive or all-in information about those things I'm going to mention, but at least to set the ball rolling, you can contact us, you can go online, you can search for information wherever you can find them to enrich your position before you make your decision. So please do not see this as an all-in or comprehensive information. But the first point I'm going to start from, interestingly, will be the point of entrepreneurship. Yes, entrepreneurship. You will be surprised that I am talking about entrepreneurship as a means of getting your money to work for you. I believe some of you will begin to see the dots I'm trying to connect. And then I'm sure there will be a question in your mind. But right now, I am employed. Or right now, I am engaged with this, engaged with that. Yes. So, when it comes to entrepreneurship, I want to flag this point to you that there are actually 2 points or 2 channels through which you can become an entrepreneur. The first is where, because of retirement, you make a plan to pursue a passion, to pursue or to solve a problem, or to make a better use of your skills for yourself. So what am I saying? I'm saying maybe you are just starting and you are 22, you are 25. When you remember that you are soon or at some point going to retire, you can actually explore the possibility of being an entrepreneur, meaning that you set a target 15 years, 5 years, 3 years, 20 years, depending on what it requires and how ready you think you are, and you pursue that dream to the point that when you stop your daily grind, you are not necessarily having to go fold your arms, lift up your legs, but you have something that is going that you could give your experience to, that you give your consulting services to, that you give your capacity to. Because you've planned for it, it should be running on its own by the time you are retired, meaning that it does not require you to be there 24/7 for it to happen. Sincerely speaking, this is one of the best preparations you can make for retirement. And I request you to please go to our library on this channel. We have a lot of content we've shared on how do you switch from where you are to become an entrepreneur? What should you worry about? What do you need? What do you require? I believe it will give you a lot of insight as to how to make this happen. Because if you succeed in entrepreneurship, you will realize that, like I said, it's one of the surest way to ensure that when you stop working for money, your money start working for you. That is the well-known road to entrepreneurship. But let me introduce to you a second road to entrepreneurship, which is where you become an investor. I'm not talking about buying shares now. I'm talking about being an angel investor. I'm talking about being a part of a business that is just starting or that required some capital. A slightly different from just buying shares of the stock exchange, which I will talk about down the line. This is you. While you are active, you've got your networks, you've got your strength, you've got your skills, you've got your ability. You'll find something of interest that somebody else is investing his energy and time in, and you have an opportunity to partner, put in your money, put in your skills. What you get goes beyond just dividend at the end of the journey. Depending on how you structure it, it could involve a salary, meaning while you're actually being paid in the other job, you are earning a salary now, which, if you understand what we've said about savings, you can begin to save. It could involve you doing profit share, but beyond that is that your stake there is guaranteed and can continue to grow depending on how successful the business eventually becomes. Therefore, in this journey and talk about entrepreneurship, remember that you don't necessarily have to resign your job before you become an entrepreneur. You don't necessarily have to also wait until you are old before you become an entrepreneur. You can actually start now. If you check our channel, you'll see how. In addition, you can find a good business that you understand, that you know how to do, that you are interested in, partner and do the investment now that will give you beyond dividend and can ensure your retirement financials in a manner that it gives you a lot of peace of mind. I am determined not to be long-winded in this series of videos, so I need to draw the curtain on this, but don't forget that entrepreneurship is one of the best means of assuring your financial independence and financial security when you retire. I hope to be back next week to take the conversation further. Thanks for being here this week. Don't ever forget, T-Mac is still my name, D-Li is still the channel, and whatever you do, remember that all we are trying to do here is what? Make a little difference. Thanks for being here, and I'll see you next week. Bye.